So we will be discussing some incidents from mother's life. Let me go a little bit before that into the philosophical basis of this Shakti Tattva in Hinduism. Because to understand what mother is, what this Mahashakti is, why we worship her, we should understand the place of Shakti, the place of energy in this cosmic design of this universe and in what we are calling God. Why God manifests himself as Shakti? Why is Mahashakti worshipped? For the simple reason, she is the energy behind the universe. She is the cause for all movement, action, energy. She is the cause whenever we are seeing something, hearing something, thinking, as long as we are bound to this senses, this mind, trapped in this body, it is only mother that we can relate to. For the simple reason that she is the energy behind all of these functions. Without Shakti, Brahman cannot function. Pure consciousness comes into manifestation as life through the power of Shakti. And this is the importance of Shakti, the divine energy of this universe. So, Sankhya psychology tells us that the ultimate reality is a combination of Purusha and Prakriti. Purusha is pure consciousness, what we are calling Brahman in Vedanta. And Prakriti is what we are calling Shakti. She is the divine energizer of this universe. She is the energy which brings Brahman into manifestation as life. So you can relate to this great Mahashakti directly. This is the Shakti Tattva. The importance of Shakti in our own system has to be understood. Vital energy is responsible for your entire mind mechanism. Swami Vivekananda says thought itself, it is nothing but refined vital energy. So this vital energy manifests as your thought, your ideation, emotion, as your will. It manifests as everything. Movement is due to the presence of Shakti. Thought is due to the presence of Shakti. And that is why if vital energy leaves the body, then there is no manifestation of life. So this important point has to be understood. In the cosmic design, she is Mahashakti who enlivens consciousness and makes manifestation possible. In the life of Shankaracharya, the 8th century AD philosopher, there's a very beautiful incident which tells us about this Shakti Tattva and how Shankaracharya himself understood the glory of this Mahashakti. Shankaracharya was this incident happened in Kashi, in Varanasi. And Shankaracharya was going towards the Ganges, the river Ganga, for his bath. And on the footsteps of a ghat, as he was proceeding, he saw a lady. It was a narrow lane. And there he saw near the ghat a lady sitting with a dead body beside her. And she was sitting, obviously he thought maybe it's her husband who has passed away. And this lady was sitting there and just looking at him. And as he came nearer, he requested her, "Mother, can you please move the body a bit so that I can go forward towards my bath in the Ganga?" Now this lady immediately said that, "Well, it is you who claim that everything is Brahman. Only Brahman is and all is Brahman. So then this also is Brahman. Why don't you ask Brahman to move?" This question stumped Shankaracharya. He immediately thought that this is no ordinary woman. She is actually trying to tell him that Brahman himself cannot move. It is only when Brahman is conjoined with Shakti, with vital energy, he becomes capable of life. Now vital energy has left. So although Brahman is there, he cannot manifest as life. So you see what a profound truth she is leading him towards. And then Shankaracharya understood this Shakti Tattva, the need for vital energy, Shakti to manifest consciousness as life. Shiva becomes his entire manifestation, his creation through the power of Shakti. All doing, thinking, feeling, willing, everything is due to the power of Shakti. And without Shakti, Shiva cannot move. Brahman is not capable of manifestation. So when he grasped this tattva, he immediately bowed down to that woman, who was none other than Shakti herself, who had come to teach him in that form. So this is the great Shakti tattva of Hinduism, the importance given to this divine cosmic energy, who is responsible for energizing everything. All divine personalities who have come from this culture, that is why they have been Shakti worshippers. They have understood the importance of this Shakti. Look at the life of Sri Ram. Any important incident in his life, he first worshipped Shakti. Even before the death of Ravan, he worships Mother Shakti so that he gets the power to defeat the demon king. Sri Ramakrishna was throughout his life a Shakti worshipper. And his entire life was dedicated to Mother Kali, as you know. So the importance given to Shakti is great in our culture. Holy Mother Sri Sharda Devi, we look upon her as that very Shakti who came in a very motherly form. And that is why she holds within herself immense power. Sri Ramakrishna used to tell Hriday, who was his nephew, he would tell him, well, if you hurt this, which means himself, you will still get forgiven for that. But if you hurt the being who is in her, in Sri Sharda Devi, even Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar cannot forgive you. They cannot save you. So it shows that the importance he is giving to Shakti. And in mother's life, she comes to us in very simple motherly guise, but she holds this great power because, you see, she has the power to actually manifest Shakti divinity in a most sattvic form. And there is no expression even, no too much expression in mother. Have you seen this holding great power but yet not expressing it? This must be such a great capacity. So this capacity you find in the life of Sri Sharda Devi. She holds great power within herself, but hardly there is an expression of that power. She was the person who accepted the puja of Sri Ramakrishna, isn't it, during the Shodashi puja? She was the person who accepted the fruit of his entire sadhana, his entire tapasya. So this is the great strength that mother holds within herself, but she appears before us just as a mother in very simple guise.